Hello guys, this is Anirudh Kale from Andy Dhosek Pune. Thanks a lot for your overwhelming response for the previous Q&A section video, and I like your comments a lot, and here I am on your request to give an interview in a section called Talk with an Entrepreneur. So firstly, I like to introduce myself and my company. So I am Anirudh Kale, as you know. So my company is Andy Infosec. I am the CEO and founder of Andy Infosec. In Andy Infosec, we deal in three sectors of cybersecurity. It's a purely cybersecurity based company, and the three sectors or the three verticals are training, research and services. In training, we train people for various cybersecurity related things like VAPT, red teaming, mobile application security, and various courses. In research, we perform research activities in various sectors in cybersecurity, and in services, we provide services to small scale as well as large scale companies for VAT, red teaming and various stuff. So as I was going through your comments, most of the students wanted an interview with me. So here I am to have an interview with you. So as per me, the quality which you need is firstly idea. You should have a right idea about what business or what area you want to focus while becoming an entrepreneur. Okay? Nowadays, everyone are trying to become entrepreneurs in India. Many people get into entrepreneurship nowadays, but they do not succeed as they do not have a right idea towards it. Okay. So whenever you are trying to become an entrepreneur, what you need to do is have a right idea. Like when I tried to do business while doing Andy Infosec, the pain area which I saw in cybersecurity is there is no proper training available in cybersecurity. So when I got into this business, my main focus was to train people practically and not theoretically, by which I can bridge the gap between what the education system is providing and what actually is needed in the job, right? So I focused on the idea. So if you have a right idea, you can move forward towards it. Then the second thing which I say is a plan. Then you need a plan to execute that idea. So if you have a right idea, so when I say idea, that is not need that the idea should be something unique or something, okay? I give this example in many of my sessions and I like to repeat it. Like for example, near your college campus, then you don't have any canteen or anything. Okay, so as most of you are students and you go to college every day, I assume you go to college every day. So when near your college, there is no canteen or something available. So in such situations, being an entrepreneur, what someone will think is, I'll launch something which is unique in your area. But at the same time, the pain area is the basic thing like tea or vada pav is also not available in your area. So as an entrepreneur, what you should focus is that there is no basic facility like tea or snacks in your area, or you will try to innovate something like pizza or burgers there. So when as an entrepreneur, you need to focus that firstly you should give them what is not available there. So you should capture the need of the public, and once you capture the need, you can gain the right capital which you need to expand your business, right? So the initial capital which you want to gain for your new ideas to implement will be acquired from this kind of business, and then you can spend that capital which you have acquired from this basic needs to generate something new, like as I said, pizza or burger or anything. So business is not other than this. It is similar to this. You need to capture the need of the audience, and accordingly you should plan your business. Okay, so when I say plan, so this comes under planning. Then the third quality which I'll say is research. So how did I came to know that there is no canteen or no facility near the college or something, right? This came from the research I did before getting into the business. Okay, so when you get an idea, after that idea, what you need to do is to have a proper research towards it. You need to check if the idea is valid, if that works over there, is it executable, will you be able to manage it, and similar things. And if such kind of research is done, then only you can do your business in the right way. The fourth quality which I'll say is focus and hard work. Okay, so to do proper research and to execute your plan very well, you need to have a proper focus and hard work involved into it. If you have a proper focus towards it, then only you will be able to do the hard work needed to execute your idea. Okay, and then fifth thing which comes into picture is capital. So when I say capital, now only I give an idea that how you can generate your capital. Other than that, there are most of the companies or entrepreneurs or different banks or firms who provide you capital for a startup nowadays. So there are different competitions too, where you can present your idea and you can gain capital. So as an entrepreneur, I'd like to tell you that most of the people nowadays are not comfortable in sharing their ideas, but you should be always comfortable while sharing your ideas with everyone. Even if someone uses your idea, that's your success, not their success. Because without investing anything, you got to know that one of your idea is working. And if one of your idea works, others can also work. So don't hesitate in sharing your ideas with others. And always look forward for executing your idea in right way. And always keep your mind open for innovative ideas and keep sharing it with people. You never know that you can get a mentor from there and who will help you into executing your idea better. Maybe you'll get investors. Maybe you'll get some good partners. You never know. In these days, anyone can be helpful in any way. So be patient. And this is according to these are five main things needed to become an entrepreneur. So believe me guys, education plays a very important role when it's come to entrepreneurship. So whenever I was doing engineering, I used to think that why am I doing it and what is the benefit towards it. But the different phases while we do education, that helps us to carry on different processes when you become an entrepreneur. Education not only means having education as depending on the certifications or depending on the degrees you have. It is the main pillar when it comes to executing your plan as an entrepreneur. Okay, so education helps you to execute your plan in a better way, by which you can have a deep knowledge about what you are doing. So you can, education helps you in different ways, like you need to do various calculations, like in how many times or phases that the business will get executed, what ideas can be executable, what can be not. You need to think on various aspects like the scalability of your business, then the reach of your audience and different things. And this all comes when you are educated, right? So believe me, education is important. It can be any kind of education, but basic subject knowledge is important whenever you try to do a business. Like while I am doing a cybersecurity business and I have zero knowledge about cybersecurity, then how will I get work done from my employees or the other people? So only when you have a subject knowledge about it, you will not get fooled by other people. So it is not that if you are not educated, then you will not be able to do business. But at least you should have a basic subject knowledge. Like if you see Tata or Reliance, do the owner of the company have all knowledge about all technologies they are working in? But they have a proper knowledge that how the work should be taken care of. Due to which they are the biggest companies in India today. So education plays a vital role here. So you should learn to outsource things which Tata and Reliance do, and by which you can grow your business on and when it's needed. So this is what I'll say when it comes to education. So whenever you try to go against the flow, there will be obstacles in your way, but definitely you need to cross them to become a good entrepreneur. So when it comes to society is, what do you mean by society? Your relatives and your other people. There are people who are going to pull your legs whenever or whatever you try to do, but that doesn't mean that you need to stop that. And when it comes to my case, there were people who used to say that why are you trying to do the business? You should do a proper job when you can get constant income into the job. But in business, there is no fixed income. There are many problems to face. There is no stable life cycle or lifestyle. But when you're trying to do something different, risk should be taken. And believe me, it's worth taking the risk when you become an entrepreneur. Even when Coca-Cola launched itself, then only 25 bottles were sold in its first year. So if they would have given up at that time, it wouldn't have been the biggest brand today in the soft drinks. In business, you should believe in yourself and believe in your idea. Anyone can't be an entrepreneur overnight, right? You need to take too much of efforts and too much of research and too much of hard work towards it. You should learn to outsource things. You should be open for new ideas. You should be open to take input from other people. And only you can be a good entrepreneur. Society is going to say what they're going to say. But what you need to do is just ignore and move forward towards your goal. Definitely yes. The family support is must when you become an entrepreneur. There are different factors like emotional support, capital, then as you said, society. Many things, right? So this all things need to be faced, and while facing all this, you need to be of your family besides you. Family support helps you to achieve mental stability. Only when your mind is stable, you can focus on new ideas and execute your business in very different ways. So family support is definitely important when it comes to business to become a successful entrepreneur. To be very frank, no. Age doesn't matter in our country. I, being a young entrepreneur, is also welcomed in our country. At the same time, I have students who come to train for cybersecurity in the age of 35 plus or 45 plus. So if they can come in this age, why not you? You still are young people. So age definitely doesn't matter when it comes to our country. It's just like as the previous question said, the society sometimes raises questions as we still have different beliefs. But believe me, there's nothing like age. If you have the right passion and the right qualities, you can do wonders at any age. So even if you are 18 plus or you are 45 plus, doesn't matter. If you are passionate enough to do that, definitely you can achieve your goal and become a successful entrepreneur. Hope this interview of mine inspires you and takes you one step closer to becoming an entrepreneur. Don't hesitate in getting in touch with me if you need anything or any kind of support. Wish you all the best for your bright future and career, and see you soon. Thank you, guys.